possessive phrase or mudaf mudafilay. This noun, this type of phrase is formed with the combination of two nouns. Before this, let me explain you what is this phrase or fragment is. The sifa mausuf, the jar majroor and the mudaf mudafilay are the fragments. What is a fragment? Fragment is more than a word but less than a sentence. Okay, this is not a complete sentence but it is a fragment. So we are learning one more type of fragment. This is called as mudaf mudafilay. And this type of phrase is formed with the combination of two nouns. Let's explain, let's see what are the conditions for the two nouns to be. The first noun is called as the mudaf. It will always be an indefinite noun or a nakira noun. And in no case will it take the article al. Okay, so it's a combination of two nouns and the two nouns should always be together, like in jar majroor, when you have something like jar and the majroor comes, its victim comes right after the jar. And in case of sifa mausuf, it's not the case. The sifa could be somewhere and in between you'll get a jar majroor and then you have a mausuf. But in case of mudaf mudafilay, these two nouns should be next to each other. And the first noun is called as mudaf. This it will always be an indefinite noun or a nakira noun. Nakira noun ends with a tanween and in no case it will take the article al. The next point says the last letter of the first noun will have a single fatha or single kasra or a single dhamma, but will never have a fatha tanween, a kasra tanween or a dhamma tanween. Okay, the first noun is a mudaf and it is always a nakira noun. So let's take an example for a nakira noun. Let's take rasulun. So this is a nakira noun as per the point number 2. And in no case it will take an article al. So if you write al, if it becomes ar rasulu, okay, but it says it never takes an article al. So we are writing rasulun. But the third point says the last letter of the first noun will have a single fatha or single dhamma or a single kasra, but will never have in a tanween form. But now we have rasulun in the tanween form. So what do we do? As per this condition, the mudaf is a nakira noun and it should end with a single vowel. Okay, so instead of rasulun, if we say rasulu, we can't even take ar-rasulu. If we take all the tanween drops, we can say it is ar-rasulu. But this, the condition, second condition says it in no case will take an article al. So the mudaf is without an al and without a tanween. So got this? It will be rasulu. It will be an akira noun but without a tanween. And the fourth point says the second noun is called as the mudaf ilay. What is it called? It's called as mudaf ilay. It is generally a definite noun or a marifa noun by itself or particularized by an al. So there are exceptions to this rule. Okay, we'll be learning the exceptions about this rule. But for now, remember the second noun is called as mudaf ilay. It is generally a marifa noun or a definite noun. So let's take Allahi here. Okay, so Rasulullahi. So this is a combination of two nouns. Rasulu is a nakira noun but without a tanween and without a al. And then the second noun is a marifa noun. Okay. And it is it begins with al. And the fifth point says the last letter of the second noun, that is the mudafilay, Allah is the mudafilay, will always have a kasra. There are no exceptions to this rule. So this is very, very important. So this has the second noun here is Allah and the last letter of the second noun is always, always a kasra. Okay, so this is very important. So what is mudaf mudafilay? It's a combination of two nouns. The first noun is a nakira noun or an indefinite noun. It will never take an article al, but also there is no tanween at the last letter. It will take the single fatha, single dhamma or single kasra. So this is done. And then Allahi, the second noun is a marifa noun starting with al and it will have the last letter will always have a kasra. There are no exception to this rule. And this combination is called the possessive phrase because the first noun is owned by or belongs to the second noun. So here Rasulullahi is the first noun. This is the mudaf and it belongs to the second noun Allahi. Rasulullahi, Rasul belongs to Allah. And Translate the first noun and then placed av after it and then translate the second noun. How do you translate the mudaf mudaf ilay? You translate the first noun, like for example, let's take Rasulullahi. So you translate Rasulu, messenger, and then you place an article, you place av after the first noun, that is mudaf, and then you translate the second noun. Allahi is Allah, messenger of Allah. So this is how you translate the mudaf mudaf ilayhi. And the mudaf is called as the mal, the mudaf is called as the possession or the milkiyat in Urdu, and the mudaf ilayhi is the possessor. So mudaf is called as the possession and mudaf ilayhi is called the possessor. Why? Because the first noun, the mudaf, is owned by or belongs to the second noun, mudaf ilay. So mudaf ilay is the possessor because it is the owner, and mudaf is a possession. So let's take the examples. The first example is Darus Salami. So here, this is a combination of two nouns, and the first noun is a nakira noun, and it ends, it will not end with a tanween, it has a single dhamma here. Okay, so this is a mudaf, and the second noun is the mudaf ilay. It starts with al, it's a marifa noun, and it always ends with a, the last word letter ends with a kasra, Darus Salami. So how do you translate? You translate the first noun, dar is house, and then you place an av in between mudaf and mudaf ilay, and then you translate the mudaf ilay, the second noun, peace, house of peace. Similarly, khalqullahi. So here, khalqu is the mudaf, and then it is a nakira noun, but it doesn't end, take an article al, and it will not end with a tanween. So you have a single dhamma here, khalqu, and Allahi is a mudaf ilay, and it is a marifa noun. It starts with al, and it always have a kasra on the last letter. And how do you translate? You translate the first noun mudaf, that is khalqu is the creation, and you put an av in between, and then you translate the second noun, Allahi is Allah, creation of Allah. So whenever you see of in the translation, you have to always and always remember it is mudaf mudaf ilay. So when you're confused with two nouns, second noun having a kasra, if you're confused if it is a mudaf mudaf ilay or no, just look for the translation. If you have of in between, then it is of in the translation, then it is a mudaf mudaf ilay. And sometimes what happens, like for house of peace, you might say, instead of creation of Allah, you can also say Allah's creation. Okay, this is the other way of saying creation of Allah, right? You can say Allah's creation. So don't get confused, like I said in the translation. If you have av, then it is only, then it is a mudaf mudaf ilay. No, if instead of saying creation of Allah, you can say Allah's creation. This is the other way of saying creation of Allah. So when you say Allah's creation, right? So you're talking about the creation of Allah, right? So even if you say like Allah's creation or something like this, then also it is a mudaf mudaf ilay. The next example is Yawmul Qiyamati. So here, Yawmu is the mudaf. It is a nakira noun, but it doesn't end with a tanween. It ends with a single dhamma. And Al Qiyamati is the mudaf ilay. It is a marifa because it starts with al, and it always have the last kasra on the last letter. So this is Al Qiyamati is the mudaf ilay. So how do you translate? You translate the mudaf first, yawm is the day, and then you put an av in between, and then you translate the second noun, Al Qiyamati is the judgment. So day of judgment, mudaf mudaf ilay. And let's take the other examples, that is Rasulullahi. This is the example which I had taken in the beginning. So Rasulu is the mudaf here, and it is a nakira noun but without a tanween. And then Allahi is the mudaf ilay. It is the marifa noun. It starts with al, and the last letter always takes a kasra. You translate the first noun, mudaf, messenger, and then you put an av in between, and then you translate the second noun, Allah, messenger of Allah. Similarly, Kitabullahi. Here Kitabu is our mudaf. It is a nakira noun. It will not end with a tanween. It will not take an al. It will have a single fatha, single vowel. And then the second noun is the Allahi, is the mudaf ilay. It is a marifa noun. It starts with al, and then it always have a kasra on the last letter. And you translate the first noun mudaf Kitabu is book, and then you place an av in between, and then you translate the second noun. Allah is Allah, book of Allah. Similarly, min azabin nari. So min is our jar, and because of min, you have azabin nari, have a kasra on the last letter. So, but we are concerned about two nouns coming together, the second noun having a kasra. So two noun, azab is the first noun, and it is a mudaf, and it is a nakira noun, but the irab is single kasra here. So, and the second noun is the mudaf ilai an nari. It always starts with an, and then, I mean, it generally starts with al. It is a marifa noun in general. And the second noun, the last letter of the second noun always have a kasra. Azab in nari. You translate the first noun. Min is from, and azab is the punishment. And then you place an av in between. And then the second noun, an nar, is the fire, punishment of the fire. Now, some of the examples in which the second noun is an indefinite noun. So this is an exception to the point number 4. What did the point number 4 says? This says the second noun, that is a mudaf ilay, is generally a definite noun or a marifa noun, right? It says in general it's a marifa noun, but it can be a nakira noun too. So that's what is this is we are explaining about the exception here. Some examples in which the second noun, the mudaf ilay, is an indefinite noun or the nakira noun. So let's take the examples here. The first one is qawlu rasulin. So here qawlu is our mudaf. This is a nakira noun without a tanween and without an al. It has a single dhamma. And the next, the mudaf ilai. Generally, what did we learn? The second noun mudaf ilai was always, I mean, generally it was a marifa noun. But in this case, this is a nakira noun. This is a mudaf ilai, but it is a nakira noun because it is ending with a tanween. It ends with a kasra tanween here. Right, but still, how do you know it's a mudaf mudaf ilay? Because it's a combination of two nouns. The first noun is a nakira noun without a tanween, without an al. The second noun, the last letter of the second noun, always take a kasra. It can even be a kasra tanween or a single kasra, but it should have a kasra. So rasulin is the second noun, that is a mudaf ilay. So you translate the first noun, qawlu is a word, and then you place an av in between, and then you translate rasulun is a messenger, right? If it would have been like ar-rasuli, then it would have been the messenger, because al is for the prefix, the al is for the, and rasulun is the nakira noun, it's a messenger of any messenger, right? And then next example is jaza'u sayyi'atin. So here jaza'u is our mudaf, and this is a nakira noun without a tanween. It just has a single dhamma and without an al. And the second noun is sayyi'atin. It's a mudaf ilay, and the last letter on the mudaf ilay is a kasra tanween, and this is in the form of a nakira noun here. So you translate the first noun mudaf, jaza is punishment. You place an av in between, and then you translate the second noun, sayyi'atin is a sin. So punishment of a sin. And the next example is mithqalu dharratin. So here mithqalu is the mudaf here. This is the nakira noun without a tanween. This has a single dhamma, and dharratin is mudaf ilayhi. This has a kasra on the last letter, a kasra tanween. So mithqalu dharratin, you translate mithqala is the weight, and then you place an av in between for mudaf mudaf ilayhi, and the dharratin is a particle. So mithqalu dharratin is mudaf mudaf ilayhi combination. It's a combination of two nouns, the second noun having a kasra or a kasra tanween. And laumatu la'imin. So here laumatu is a mudaf, and it ends with a single dhamma. This is a nakira noun without a tanween, without an al. And then la'imin is the mudaf ilay. This is a nakira noun because it ends with a tanween, and this is a kasra tanween here. And then mudaf mudaf ilay is a combination of two nouns, second noun having a kasra. And you translate laumatu, the mudaf, blame, and then you put an av in between, and la'imin is the blamer. Blame of a blamer. It is not it is blame of a blamer, because it's a nakira noun, not a marifa noun. There's a small correction here in the book on page 40. Okay, so this is clear. Next, go to the note. Make a note that the combination of nouns with pronouns is also a possessive phrase or mudaf mudaf ilay. Okay, so the combination of nouns with pronouns, we have learned in the previous lessons, the combination of nouns and pronouns. But here it says the combination of nouns with pronouns is also possessive phrase or mudaf mudaf ilai. For example, if you say kitabuhu, right? Kitabuhu, how do you translate? You translate the pronoun first, his, and then the book. And then here what happens? The tanween is dropped. It was actually kitabun and plus the pronoun who. It become kitabuhu, the tanween drops. And it means the book is owned by or belongs to him, right? Now again you have the possession and the possessor case here, right? Kitabu is the possession and who is the possessor or the owner, right? He is the owner of the book. Note that only when the mudaf ilayhi is a noun, it ends with a kasra. What did we say in the previous, on the fifth point? It says the last letter of the second noun or the mudaf ilayhi will always have a kasra, no exceptions to it. That was in the case when there were two nouns. But here it's a combination of noun plus pronoun, right? So in that case, this rule doesn't apply. So since the mudaf ilayhi is a pronoun, this rule doesn't apply. You can take like kitabuhu, rasuluhu, baituhu, and abduhu. So there are so many things like whatever examples with noun and pronoun, it's not necessary, or this rule doesn't apply that the second noun should have a kasra, because the it depends on the attached pronouns, right? So all the pronouns with all the nouns with the pronouns are mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So let's take examples from the Quran. Following are examples of possessive phrases from the Quran. So the first example is fi sabilillahi bi amwalikum. So here fi sabilillahi, fi is our jar because of fi sabilu became sabili, right? But now we are concerned about our mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So here sabilillahi, this is a combination of two nouns. Sabili is mudaf and allahi is the mudaf ilayhi. Because it's a combination of two nouns, the second noun having a kasra on the last letter, allahi, right? So how do you translate? You translate sabil first, sabil is path, and then you put av in between, and then you translate the second noun mudaf ilayhi, Allah, path of Allah. So this is the first set of mudaf mudaf ilayhi in this ayah. And again, look for bi amwalikum. So what is bi? Bi is our jar. And amwali, because of bi amwalu became amwali. Okay, so bi amwali is our jar majroor. And look for what is there again after amwali. There is a kum here. So amwalikum, this is a combination of noun and pronoun kum. Right? This was actually amwalun plus the pronoun kum. So what happens when you when you join a pronoun to a noun, the tanween drops and it becomes amwalukum. And here we have amwalikum because of b. So because of b, amwalu became amwali. So even this is a mudaf mudaf ilayhi combination. So how do you translate? It's your wealth or wealth of yours, right? You put an of, and the other way of saying is wealth of yours, right? So you have of. So you can say either your wealth or wealth of yours. The next example is ulaika ashabul jahimi. So here ashabul jahimi is a combination of mudaf mudaf ilai. Ashabu is the mudaf here, and al jahimu is our mudaf ilai. He, it is in the marifa form, and this last letter is having a kasra. So you translate the first noun, ashab is the companions, you put an av in between, and then you translate al jahimi is the hell, companions of the hell. So mudaf mudaf ilay ashabul jahimi. And next one is wadhkuru ni'matallahi alaykum. So here ni'matallahi is a combination of mudaf mudaf ilay, because it's ni'mat is the first noun, this is the mudaf, and allahi is the second noun, mudaf ilayhi. It's a combination of two nouns, the second noun having a kasra on the last letter. And how do you translate? They translate the ni'ma is the bounty, and then you put an av in between, mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, and then you translate the second noun, mudaf ilayhi, allahi is Allah, bounties of Allah. And the next example is ma unzila ilayka mir rabbika. So here, and whatever is revealed to you from your Lord. So here This is a combination of noun and a pronoun. So what did we say? Any combination of noun with a pronoun is always mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. This was actually rabbun plus ka. The pronoun, attached pronoun ka. So what happened when you attach a pronoun with a noun? The tanween drops and then it becomes rabbuka. Why is it rabbika here? Because of our jar majroor, min is our jar majroor. Because of min jar, rabbu became rabbi. It became rabbika, mer rabbika. But for now, we are just concerned about the combination of noun and a pronoun, which is a mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So rabbika is your lord, or you can say lord of yours. Right? You can say your lord or lord of yours. This is a mudaf mudaf ilayhi. وَذَٰلِكَ جَزَاءُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. So here, جَزَاءُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ is a combination of mudaf mudaf ilayhi. جَزَاءُ is the mudaf, which is not having a tanween. And الْمُحْسِنِينَ is the mudaf ilayhi. So here, al-muhsinina, right? So ya noon ending, this is actually the plural form. So what so nouns ending with waw noon and ya noon are in the plural form. So here it is ending with ya, and look for the last letter, muhsinina, right? So noon is having a kasra. So this is a combination of two nouns. The second noun is having a kasra. So this is jaza, is you translate the first noun, jaza is a reward, you put an av in between, and then muhsinina is the righteous. So the reward of righteous. And here in case of like, unlike in sifa mausuf, we have to check for the gender, number, type of noun and irab. Here you don't have to worry about, you know, matching the gender or number or type of noun or irab. Only it's just, let's look for the combination of two nouns. You know, they are next to each other. And then the second noun is having a kasra. The first noun is a nakira noun, but without a tanween and without an al. That's it. And وَيَسُدَّكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَعَنِ الصَّلَاةِ. So here, ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ is our مُدَافِ مُدَافِ لَيْهِ. ذِكْرِ is مُدَافِ and اللَّهِ is مُدَافِ لَيْهِ. It was actually ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ because of our jar majroor and an, ذِكْرُ became ذِكْرِ. So ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, ذِكْر is the remembrance, and then you put an av in between, and then you translate the second noun, Allah, Allahi, and the second noun is having a kasra here. So this is a combination of mudaf mudaf. ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ is remembrance of Allah or ذِكْر of Allah. So alhamdulillah, we have completed the mudaf mudaf ilayhi, the chapter number 12. Let's take some examples from the Quran. So this is Suratul Kahf. Here we have Anna Ashabal Kahfi. So here we have Ashabal Kahfi. So Ashab is the mudaf here, and Ashab is the companion, and Al Kahfi is the mudaf ilayhi. This is a combination of two nouns. The second noun is having a kasra on the last letter, and the first noun is a nakira noun, but without a tanween, it has a single fatha here. So this is a combination of mudaf mudaf ilayhi. If you are confused by looking at two nouns, just look for the translation, and you have av in the translation, right? This is companions of the cave. And if you go down, you see min ayatina. So what did I say? Even the combination of noun and a pronoun is also a mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So this was ayatun plus na, the pronoun na. Because of min, min is our jar majroor. What does the min do? It puts in kasra on the last letter. So instead of ayatun, it makes it as ayatin. But when it combines with the pronoun, the tanween drops and it becomes ayatina. Right? So ayatina is a combination of noun and pronoun, and always a combination of noun plus pronoun are mudaf mudaf ilayhi, our signs or signs of ours. And again we have rabbana here. Rabbana is a combination of rabbun plus na, right? So rabbun, what happens when you join a pronoun to a noun? The tanween drops and it becomes a rabbana. And it's a combination of noun plus pronoun is mudaf mudaf ilayhi. It's our lord again. And amrina, again you have min amrina. So here Amrina is it was actually Amrun plus pronoun na. Because of min, the jar majroor Amrun became Amrin, and because of na, the tanween drops and it becomes Amrina. And it's a combination of noun plus pronoun. This is mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So in this ayah we have like three mudaf mudaf ilayhi. And let's take a different surah, Surat al-Imran. And here we say min ahlil kitabi. So here ahl is the people and al-kitabi is the book, right? So here ahli is the mudaf and al-kitabi is the mudaf ilayhi. It's a combination of two nouns. The first noun is a nakira noun without a tanween and it has a single kasra, and al-kitabi, the second noun, is the marifa noun and the second noun is having a kasra on the last letter. And why is it ahli? Because of min. Min is our jar majroor. So min, because of min, ahlu became ahli here. So this is ahlul. It was actually ahlul kitabi. Because of min, it became among ahlil kitabi, the people of the book. And in the translation, you can see av here, people of the book. Ayatillahi is our mudaf mudaf ilayhi. Ayat is the mudaf. And Allahi is the mudaf ilayhi. Why is there a kasra on the ayati? Because of b. B is our jar majroor. So you have ayat. Ayat are the verses. And then in the translation, you have av. And then you translate the Allah is the marifa noun. And the last letter has the kasra on the word of Allah. And ajruhum. So here you have ajruhum. Ajruhum, what did I tell you? The combination of noun and a pronoun is mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So here the ajru is the mudaf. It was actually ajrun plus hum, the pronoun hum. What happens when you join a pronoun to a noun? The tanween drops and it becomes ajruhum. So this is their reward or reward of them, right? So this is a combination of mudaf mudaf ilayhi. Similarly, inda rabbihim, this was actually rabbun plus the pronoun hum. So what happens when you join with a noun with a pronoun? The tanween drops, it becomes a rabbuhum. Why is it rabbihim here? It's because of inda. I told you it's a inda because of the on page 27, this is a list where which gives kasra to the noun coming after it. Inda rabbihim. Jannatul Firdausi, Suratul Kahf again. So here it's talking about for them will be gardens of the paradise. So here Jannatu is the mudaf. It's a nakira noun without a tanween. It has a single dhamma here and without an al. And Al Firdausi is a mudaf ilai. It is a marifa noun because it starts with al and it has a kasra on the last letter. And also, if you are confused, you can take gardens of the paradise. So if you see of in the translation, it is a mudaf mudaf ilai combination. And it's qulubukum again. Qulubukum is a combination of noun and a pronoun. It was actually qulubun plus kum. So qulubun, the tanween drops, it becomes qulubukum. It becomes your hearts or hearts of yours. Qulub is the plural for qalb. Allahi. So here, khashya. Khashya is the fear. Khashyati is the mudaf here. And it is having a kasra because of min. Min is our jar majroor. And Allahi is the mudaf ilayhi. It is a marifa noun and ends with a kasra. And in the translation, you can see fear of Allah. So this is a combination of mudaf mudaf ilayhi. They are the nouns coming next to each other. Kalamallahi. So here, kalamallahi, kalam is are the words. Kalam is a mudaf. And Allahi is the mudaf ilayhi. Because it is a marifa noun and the last letter.